Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel Electronics for Gate by Kota Venkanna. My mobile number 630-5826-909. Today I want to discuss the review of coordinate systems. The topic is review of coordinate systems. In this review of coordinate system, the topic is electrostatics. What is electrostatics? Here, the electrostatics is the study of forces between two charges. That is electrostatics. In this electrostatics, the subtopic is Coulomb's law. Today, I want to discuss the Coulomb's law. What is Coulomb's law? Is that So, Charles Augustin de Coulomb
was a French scientist. After conducting several experiments on charged bodies, he concluded that there exists a force between them. He formulated a law known as Coulomb's law. That is, here Q1 is the charge, Q2 is the charge, here Q1 is charge, Q2 is charge. If Q1, Q2 between Q1 is positive and Q2 is positive, in between these two equal signs, same signs, the repulsion force exists. Force is there between these two. Force is there. That force is known as repulsion force. And similarly, Q1 is the charge and Q2 is the charge. So Q1 is positive, Q2 is negative. In between these two, the force exists. This force is known as attraction force. Attraction force. So here, by concluding this, any of the between two charges, some force exists. Some force exists. So here, the force between any of the two charged bodies is directly proportional to, force is directly proportional to Q1, Q2. And similarly, in between Q1 and Q2, the distance is indicated with smaller. Here also, Q1 and Q2, the distance is indicated with smaller. And the force between these two charges and universally proportional to 1 by r square. Universally proportional to r square, that is F directly proportional to 1 by r square. That is also known as inversely proportional to r square. Here Q1, Q2 directly proportional to F. Here r square is inversely proportional to F. Here Q1, Q2 increases, F is increases. Here r is increases, F is decreases. So these two are combined as F is directly proportional to Q1, Q2 by R square. So this is written as F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon Q1, Q2 by R square. So this is known as Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law units F is the directly F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 by R square. So Q1 is the charge, Q2 has the charge, and R is the distance between two charges. So here epsilon is the permittivity of the medium. Epsilon is permittivity of the medium. So this is known as Coulomb's law. Newton's the units were forces newtons. The units for forces newtons. And force is a vector quantity. So that's why it is indicated as the AR. F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 by R square into AR. This is the Coulomb's law. This is about Coulomb's law. So here Coulomb's law, F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 by R square into AR. So here epsilon is the permittivity of the medium. Epsilon is written as epsilon is equal to epsilon naught into epsilon r. So epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space and epsilon r is the relativity of the medium. So here permittivity of free space epsilon naught is equal to 1 by 36 pi into 10 power minus 9. So this value equal to 8.854 into 10 power minus 12. And relative permittivity epsilon r for free space is equal to 1. Then for the free space the total value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught or 1 by 4 pi epsilon is equal to 9 into 10 power 9. And here ar is the unit vector along the line joining the two charges. So totally F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 by R square into AR is the Coulomb's law. This Coulomb's law. So here Q1 and Q2. Q1 is the charge, Q2 is the charge. In between these two the distance is R. Then the force on Q2 due to Q1 in free space is written as F2. F2 is equal to, so here the force on Q2 that is F2 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 by R21 square into A21. A21 is the unit vector. R21 is the distance from Q2 to Q1. And here the vector A21 is written as R2 minus R1 by modulus of R2 minus R1. So here similarly the force on Q1, the force on Q1 due to Q2 in free space is written as, that is force on Q1 is F1 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 by R12 R12 square into A12. So here A12 is written as R1 minus R2 by R1 minus modulus of R1 minus R2. So here A21 is written as R2 minus R1 by modulus of R2 minus R1. Here A12 is written as R1 minus R2 by modulus of R1 minus R2. So finally the force on Q1 due to Q2 is equal to F1, then force on Q2 due to Q1 is equal to F2. These two are magnitude, these two magnitude are same, but directions are opposite. So that's why F1 is equal to minus F2. So this is about the brief discussion of Coulomb's law. This is about brief discussion of Coulomb's law. In next class, we will discuss the problems on Coulomb's law. So, thank you. For every updates and daily classes, subscribe my channel Electronics for Gate by Kota Venkanna. So, my mobile number 630-58-26-909. Thank you.